You're watching CatAList. Season 3, Episode 14. Stay tuned for more shows.
Hi, I'm Melissa Donaldson. You're watching What You Like on CatAList. This week's question, what are your tips for the marketplace?
You got the cooler.
Always buy avocados and put them on everything.
Okay, so the biggest tip for the marketplace is to get soup and salad.
All right, so marketplace tip is, don't have any meal plan money? That's okay.
That is like the most perfect you can get. Also, just be creative, because you can do a lot with that.
So like pasta bar.
Salmon in your salad, so you get some protein.
And it's so worth it, that's what I do.
You have to eat a lot and eat often. Whenever you think the marketplace is not making food up your standard, just remember, you don't have to pay cash.
Don't eat carbohydrates.
Don't be like dissuaded by the fact that there's long lines, because they don't actually take that long and it's so worth it.
All right, it's more than okay to eat alone, people.
Don't eat sugar, processed sugar is bad.
Just wait in that line, because it's only like 10 minutes, actually.
I would just say avoid at all costs.
Let me tell you something. You want some tea or coffee? Don't want to wait for it, and you want food also?
So don't get eggs.
Let me tell you, you go to the green bean, you order it, you say, okay, and then you go to the marketplace, get your food, come back, it's ready. You got food, drink, same time, no waiting.
That you need to go through the right side, check right by where Jenny is to see if there are lines, and then if there aren't lines, you just go straight through. Go straight to Homestyle, because Homestyle is always good.
Everything has cancer in it, so be careful.
Put a little bit of beans on top of your Homestyle dish.
So my tips for eating in the marketplace is you really need to get creative. Like, there's a lot out there.
The moral of the story is moderation. Eat in moderation.
Toast some bread, slice some avocados and put it on the bread, and then put sriracha sauce on it.
Often it's very easy to steal cookies. I don't recommend it because it's wrong. It's morally incorrect.
When you're eating at the marketplace, it's like, food sucks, so if you're not hungry, may as well not even eat.
Still moving on the plate.
We gotta eat it.
Hold on, take a video of me eating it.
Ew. No, it's stuck.
Oh, that's still moving. Go, Chris, you got to.
I don't know.
It sucks your mouth.
I can't.
Yes, you can.
Do it.
Release your inner nerd at the Grand Park Downtown Book Fest, where all of Grand Park's literary nooks and crannies come alive in one day for book lovers both big and small.
Welcome to Fusion Burger, located on York Boulevard, where ingredients from all over the world come together to make fresh, juicy burgers. Our ingredients are freshly prepared every day. Made to order, each burger retains its original flavor. We have 16 original burgers, and they range from our original Mexican barbecue to vegan and vegetarian burgers. Happy hours from 3 p.m. to 6 p.m. Tiger Tuesday, buy a burger and a side, and drinks are on us. Located at 5933 York Boulevard, come visit us today and enjoy a nice meal with us. For more information, including a full menu, visit FusionBurgersLA.com.
Welcome to From the Archives, where we scour Oxy's records and present to you some of the forgotten fragments of its past. The following is from a 1970s promotional film about Oxy students, and we're curious to see how much has changed. Here's what we found this week from the archives.
Carol Chen has completed 1 year at Occidental College. She might go on to become a doctor or a lawyer. There's time yet to decide.
I picked up this idea of the Renaissance person, and I in fact tried to live it my first year in trying to apply myself to other areas outside of academia. It included writing for the newspaper and taking pictures and drawing, designing things and singing. It's stimulating to live this way.
I came to Oxy for the more personalized experience. The small school feel was something that I was really stoked on, coming from a small high school. And just, you know, it seemed more community-based, and I felt like I could know my professors more and meet more people.
Besides the pre-med courses, doctors especially have to be well-rounded. So one of the courses that I particularly liked was my art history class. It gave me a very good general knowledge about art, and I think that really rounded me out so that I'm not just this person who might have a lot of knowledge about medicine but can't relate to anybody else.
Oxy's, I think, emphasis on the liberal arts education has really, I think, rounded out my perspective and given me the ability to think not only in terms of the sciences, which I have majored in, but also in terms of all the other fields.
Ross Buchanan is a sophomore who studies political science and plays tight end.
I'd say I spent more hours in the library than I did in my room.
Well, I liked history a lot in high school, and so I always thought it was interesting, kind of seeing parallels between regions or countries and time periods and this, that, and the other.
My grandfather says that a college career is not a list of courses. It's a process of learning how to learn, and it's something you continue all your life.
It's even better than it sounds. This week, learn about what your tuition really supports and the donors that help fill in the rest of the pie.
Hey guys, welcome back to Africa's Dance Lessons, Spring 2013. First, we're gonna continue with the dance hall genre, so let's go. So to start us off, everyone kind of turn a little bit to the diagonal. Now, my feet are gonna step forward with my left foot. It's gonna step forward like this. 1, 2, 3, 4. At the same time, my right foot is gonna do a twist and come up. So it's 1, 2, 3, 4. So all together, it looks like this. 1, 2, 3, 4. Great job. At the same time, our arms are gonna do a wheelchair motion. So it's gonna go down, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. So all together, it looks like this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. And if you've noticed, we can dip down on the 1 and come back up after that. So let's try it all together. 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. Great job. So our second step for today involves me jumping to my left foot, bringing the right one up, like this. After I'm here, my heel is gonna lead it, and it's gonna go up, down, so 2. After that, I'm gonna jump to my right side and do the same thing on my other foot. Up, down. So all together, it looks like this. 1, 2, 1, 2, great job. Now the arms for this, just kinda go 1, 2, 1, 2. And So all together it looks like this. 1, 2, 1, 2. 1, 2, 1, 2. Great job. So our third step for today, and the last step of our dancehall genre, is this one right here. So we're gonna turn to the left, and then our hips are gonna come forward, then you wanna bend them down as you bring them back. So it's like a circle. Forward, back, forward, back. Now at the same time, the arms do a wheelchair motion, but they kinda go opposite of the hips. So when the hips come forward, the arms are back. Then they come forward. 1, 2, 3, 4. Great job. Now let's put all of the steps that we learned today together. 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Great job. So guess what we're gonna do now? We're gonna add all of the steps together from dance hall that we learned. So last semester plus this semester. Are you ready for that? I think you are. So let's go. Genre. I hope that you enjoyed it, but stay tuned for the next episode where I'll be teaching the fundamentals of belly dancing. See you then.
Do you have a talent and need an outlet? Are you completely untalented and need some entertainment on a Wednesday night? The Mortarboard Open Mic Night is just for you. This Wednesday at 8 p.m. in the cooler, Auntie M's cupcakes will be sold for $5. You're watching CatAList. Season 3, Episode 14. Stay tuned for more shows.
Welcome to The Weekly Show. My name is Nick Dodani, your host. So, remember how a few years ago the economy exploded?
Share prices continued to tumble.
Lehman Brothers was forced to declare itself bankrupt.
The largest single point drop.
And remember how the banks had a lot to do with it?
What do you think about selling securities which your own people think are crap? Does that bother you
as a hypothetical?
No, this is real.
And remember how nothing happened to them?
It's a Wall Street government.
Why do you think there isn't a more systematic investigation being undertaken?
Because then you'll find the culprits.
I don't believe I have to discuss that with you.
And remember how last year we elected Elizabeth Warren to the U.S. Senate? Well, she just had her first hearing as a member of the Senate Committee on Banking, Housing, and Urban Affairs, and beautiful things happened.
I want to ask a question about supervising big banks when they break the law. The question I really want to ask is about how tough you are, about how much leverage you really have in these settlements. And what I'd like to know is, tell me a little bit about the last few times you've taken the biggest financial institutions on Wall Street all the way to a trial. Anybody?
Awkward.
our enforcement actions is really to identify the problem and then demand a solution to it on an ongoing basis.
That's right. And then you set a price for that. Sorry to interrupt, but I just want to move this along. That's effectively a settlement. And what I'm asking is, when did you last take, and I know you haven't been there forever, so I'm really asking about the OCC, a large financial institution, a Wall Street bank, to trial?
The institutions I supervise, national banks and federal thrifts, we've actually had a fair number of consent orders. We do not have to bring people to a trial or an
Well, I appreciate that you say you don't have to bring them to trial. My question is, when did you bring them to trial? Can you identify when you last took the Wall Street banks to trial?
I will have to get back to you with the specific information.
That's really awkward.
We've got multiple people here. Anyone else want to tell me about the last time you took a Wall Street bank to trial? You know, I just want to note on this. There are district attorneys and U.S. attorneys who are out there every day squeezing ordinary citizens on sometimes very thin grounds and taking them to trial in order to make an example, as they put it. I'm really concerned that too big to fail has become too big for trial.
Celebrate Chinese New Year in style this weekend. Enjoy free cultural activities, acrobatics, music, dance, and wild festivities at the Chinese American Museum's 12th annual Lantern Festival, 12 to 7 on Saturday, March 2nd.
Hi, I'm Jordan Delano, and today I'm making my famous pasta salad, which is known throughout the land and officially endorsed by the Urban Environmental Policy Department, and particularly Professor Martha Matsuoka.
Let's get started.
All right, so here are our ingredients. 2 pounds of ditalini, 16 scallions, a cup of parsley, a cup of radicchio or red cabbage. It's much easier to find red cabbage, and it's also preferable for a lot of people who don't like bitter foods, such as Justin Berner, who hated the radicchio that was in my famous pasta salad. I'm not sure how much red wine vinegar, but that will be determined later. 6 cloves of garlic, salt, to be determined later as well, black pepper, a cup of olive oil, and 4 cans of great white northern beans. The first step is to prepare the food. Chop your scallions, cabbage, parsley, and mince the garlic. Rinse your beans and allow them to drain. Cook the pasta. You should be able to do this. While your pasta is cooking, combine your 10 tablespoons of red wine vinegar with your cup of olive oil. Add the minced garlic and chopped parsley, and add salt and pepper to taste. Once your pasta is cooled, add the oil vinegar mixture to your pasta and toss well. After you've done this, add the beans, scallions, and red cabbage. You know you can't be lazy. Never use a messy
recipe. The cake will end up crazy. Once you've mixed it together, it's ready to eat. Enjoy Jordan's famous pasta salad.
And thank you for the recipe to this famous pasta salad. Amen.
Amen.
Really good.
So good.
I wonder if we gotta have it made. You know that I love cake. Finally, it's time to make a cake.
are cooking by the book.
I cheated on you. Thank you.
CatAList is brought to you by... with special thanks to...